Gentlemen, and welcome to AOW. As you all know, my name is Chris Taylor, and well, this is the final episode of AOW until AOW Anarchy. And right now, we know for sure the main event is going to be Nate West versus Isaac Taylor in a no disqualification match. We know Marcus Young will be going against Everett Adams for the Cruiserweight Championship in a 2 out of 3 falls match. Right here, we got Jared Bowden coming out. He going one-on-one with Isaac Taylor. Isaac able to pick up a win over Leo Phoenix last week. Very impressive performance by both men. From being told, Leo will actually be moving into the Cruiserweight division. And in our main event tonight, we're going to have the third encounter between Zach Sanchez and Juan Santos. Should definitely be quite the match. Oh, and I guess one more match that got announced recently. Adam Webster will be defending his United States Championship against Dallas Cage in a tables match. So the only way for one of them to walk away with the title is to put their opponent through a table. And now here comes Isaac Taylor. Definitely been on quite the roll as of late. It's weird, it's almost as if losing his championship actually motivated him to do better here. And it's definitely shown because he's taken on all comers, literally. It's almost as if he's holding an open challenge each week and all these guys are just here answering for him and he just beats them each and every time. He's beaten DRS, Leo Phoenix, and now we're going to see if he can do the same to Jared Bowden. Only seen him in one other match here in AOW, and that was against King DRS to qualify for the Elimination Chamber. Bowden was not successful in that match. So you know he's definitely knocking off a guy like Isaac Taylor is going to boost you up in the rankings of AOW. Two-time AOW champion. First ever multi-time AOW champion. Some of the top stars we have here in AOW. Nate West as well. He's another one who been on quite the roll as of late. Both him and Isaac Taylor have been undefeated since the start of, well, actually no, it hasn't been the start of a new season, but it's after the Elimination Chamber. Both men have gone undefeated. So it's kind of hard to say who we think is going to come out on top. It won't be the first time these two faced off, but it will be an AOW in a one-on-one setting. Or, well, aside from their one-off match that happened when we first returned, they haven't ever had stakes this high in a one-on-one match, let alone an AOW. They've had one other match outside of AOW, and that was at ROX Victory Lane. Nate, surprisingly enough, no offense to him, he came out on top. Isaac Taylor definitely put up quite the fight against him. And Nate was just the better man that day. But now we see, will Isaac Taylor be able to come out on top against Jared Bowden? Isaac kind of, both men taunting each other. Face to face. Oh, Isaac right away with a punch. Now an elbow. Wasting very little time as this match starts. Isaac just going right after Bowden. Throws him off the ropes. Oh, wait a minute, Bowden with a spine buster out of nowhere. What a reversal and what a way to take control of this matchup. Elbow to the face. Oh, hitting Isaac with some strikes of his own. Throws Isaac off the ropes. Oh, Isaac blocks the elbow. Once this has him by the arm and a Pele kick right to the arm. Oh, what is this? Nice small package. Driver into the pin. One, he may have him. No, not even a two count. Oh, what a knee right to the temple of Jared Bowden as he very slowly gets back up to his feet. Oh, once again, going after that arm for that bridging armbar that Isaac has been using over the past few weeks. And Isaac just continues the beatdown, once again working that left arm of Bowden. Oh, God. I say it every time I see that move. That is just hard to watch. Once again, targeting an arm. Man, I'm surprised he hasn't injured anybody. As yet. Nice punch, now an elbow. Seems to be. Oh, wait a minute. Bowden comes back on the elbow of his own. You notice there he used his right arm. Oh, and a knee right to Isaac's arm this time, giving him a little taste of his own medicine. As I said before, you notice he used his right arm to strike. It's possible that Isaac may be inflicting too much pain on the left for him to really use it as much. Goes to the pin. One. No. Isaac able to kick out. This backhand chop has Isaac against the ropes. Oh, man. Kind of collapsing there. Isaac rolls out of the way. And again with that knee to the face. Man, Isaac so lethal with these strikes. He says knock someone out. Oh my God, he's really looking to do that though. Man. Throws Bowden into the corner. And oh man, nice knee. Now Isaac heads to the top. What's he looking for here? Telling Bowden to get up. Telling him to bring it. Oh, nice missile drop kick. Ooh. I think Isaac landed right there, but anyways, goes to the pin. One, two, he may have him. No. Bowden barely able to kick out there. Very close call there. Oh, wait a minute, has him up. Oh, but Bowden, what is this? Oh, wait a minute, here we go. Into the bridge, that nice suplex that we've seen from before. And no, Isaac barely able to kick out. Oh, look at this. Oh, God. You know, I just remembered Bowden has an arm targeting submission that he's put away many opponents with in his career outside of AOW. So both men, you got submission versus submission in this matchup. And Isaac looking to take back control. Has him in the corner. Oh, what is this? Oh, these boots right to the face of Bowden. Isaac off the ropes and up. Oh, God. Oh, that one busted Bowden wide open. I can see right now the blood running down his face. Kick to the gut. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, God! That elbow goes to the pin. Look at that, put Bowden away. One, two, no. Somehow, some way, Bowden still fighting, still trying to pick up that first win. Isaac lifts him up. Elbow to the face. With another one. Puts him into the corner. Oh man, nice overhand punch to the chest. He has that left arm locked. With Bowden coming back with a straight punch right to the face. Blocks it. Oh, both men blocking one another's strikes. Seems to have control here. Brings him back. Oh, never mind. Isaac with a belly-to-belly suplex. Oh, knocking the referee down there. I don't know if that was intentional or not. Oh, the eclipse. That stunner from the top rope goes to the pin on Bowden. One, two, three. I think we can count to 100 here. Two, three. And Isaac Taylor picks up the win over Jared Bowden. Very, very great effort put up by Bowden, but you know, Isaac, he's just, I'm not trying to say he's better, but he has a lot more experience here. Still though, like I said before, valiant effort put up by Jared Bowden. He gave it his all. He just couldn't get the job done, I guess. But you know what? Neither could Leo Phoenix, neither could King DRS. Just pretty much everyone. Damn, I just realized he jumped over the ref. That is why Isaac Taylor has won. Referee getting out of the ring. I don't blame him. Wrestling knocks you down like that. That's just disrespectful. Whether it was on accident or not, didn't hesitate at all. Just knocked him down, hit his move, and took the win. Now we move on into our next match. We're going to be seeing King TRS versus Sebastian Scott. Of one of these first two men, and it's going to be King TRS who will be coming out first. In case you haven't watched the past episodes of AOW, Sebastian Scott actually, surprisingly enough, randomly cost TRS a match. His match against Isaac Taylor. Next thing you know, his music hit, and he was just standing on the ramp and distracted TRS when he was about to put Isaac away. And, you know, since then, they've just kind of had some issues. I guess they're going to finally settle those issues here tonight. DRS makes his way down the ramp. DRS, he is, like Isaac Taylor, he's one of the biggest stars here in AOW. Of course, just because of the fact that he's been all around the world and just mastered his craft and just became one of the best wrestlers out there. Sebastian Scott. You hear the crowd booing him. And there he is, the artist, Sebastian Scott. Makes his way down the ramp now. Sebastian on many other shows such as ROX, Biohazard, Project X, many other shows that honestly this guy's pretty much everywhere. Now he's in AOW. About to enter the ring. Oh, wait a minute. DRS. What is this? Oh! Just knocking Sebastian off the apron. He didn't even get to enter the ring. Nor finish his entrance. God, throwing him into the barricade. And a straight punch to the face. Backhand chop. Oh my God. Just knocking Sebastian down. Oh God, what is this? Has him up. Oh God, oh! Throwing him face first onto the barricade. And drops the elbow on Sebastian Scott. I think that's gonna be it for these two. Oh my God. Well, now that they're gone, King TRS attacking Sebastian Scott before the match could even start. We have AOW champion coming out. He'll be taking on the debuting Carter O'Reilly. Also, I can't lie, it's pretty nice thing for Nate West to do, you know, giving some talent that's backstage and doesn't exactly get opportunities all the time. You know, giving them opportunities to face him. Who knows, maybe they'll beat him one of these times and earn themselves a championship match. Stated earlier, quite the role as of late, picking up and over Zach Sanchez, Sebastian Scott last week. Let's see if he can pick up a win over Carter O'Reilly. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. past few weeks. Even just since Nate came to AOW, he is one of the best wrestlers we have. If you can beat Nate West, you can probably beat some of the likes of Justin Harris and Isaac Taylor, just all these other guys. And Nate is, like you said before, he's a great wrestler. Part of O'Reilly, I don't really know anything about him, so we'll see what he's all about here. He has Nate in a side headlock, but wait a minute, Nate pushes him off the ropes. Oh, nice Hurricane Rana right away, taking him down. Nate, respectful thing to do. Oh, sidesteps a clothesline. And nice back suplex. See, I don't know how smart that was on Nate's part. He just pretty much gave Carter the advantage in this matchup. And oh, Nate moves out of the way, the missile drop kick. What's this? Pulls him more to the center of the ring. Oh, drops the knee. Right into the left kidney. Maybe the back spin kick. Has him up against the ropes. Irish whip. Drops down under. Nice leapfrog. Oh, went for the Hurricane Rana, but no. Carter able to connect with that spine buster. Otherwise known as the 11th Street. Nice Northern Lights suplex into the bridge. One. Nate really able to kick out there. There's Nate off the ropes. Oh, went for a super kick, I believe, but Nate caught him, hit him with a knee. Oh! That's what I call a super kick, but that time it was to the gut. Back spin kick. European uppercut has Carter cornered. Oh god, look at these kicks. Oh man, you can tell Nate's just getting angry now. And oh, nice cannonball senton. Nate's showing off to the fans a little bit here. Kicks to the gut. Oh, able to block the backhand shot. Nate blocks the elbow. Both men blocking each other's strikes. Oh, nice combination, well, sequence there by both men. Oh, O'Reilly showing off now. Oh man, look at that. Definitely paying the price for it. As Nate right back at him. Oh god, a nice combination of punches. Lifts Carter up. What is this? Irish whip. And Samoan drop by Nate West. Oh, what is this? Possibly looking for the going west. They're gonna put Carter away early. Oh, never mind. O'Reilly coming with a jawbreaker. Oh, and a super kick. Now heads to the top rope. Wait a minute. Possibly looking to put him away. Oh, went for the reverse 450 splash. Big mistake there, Nate. Oh, wait a minute. Able to sidestep him. Nice basement drop kick, taking out the knee. Rolling under the bottom rope. Climbs up. Carter goes off the ropes. And oh, Nate with a kick to the head. Heads to the top rope now. What is this? Nice double knees to the skull. Taking him down. Lifts him up. What is Nate looking for now? It's with a backstabber. Nate's signature maneuvers we've seen him use quite some time now. Heads to the top rope. Wait a minute. The shooting star press, he's able to connect, goes to the pin, they're going to put Carter away, 1, 2, 3, he got him, and Nate West, making quick work of Carter O'Reilly. Don't get me wrong, he definitely put up a fight against him. You know, Nate's AOW champion, you're not going to just come in here and beat him in your first match. Unless your name's Dallas Cage, you're not beating any champions. Congratulations to Nate West. Now we will move on into our main event. Juan Santos versus Zach Sanchez. Santos case you guys haven't been watching AOW recently, at least you faced off quite a few episodes back in a one-on-one match, and Quan was able to come out on top. Then last week they faced off again, and this time Zach came on top, so I guess they both agreed they would have one more match just to kind of determine who's the better man out of the two. So right now it's 1-1, so this is kind of a tiebreaker. Juan Santos versus Zach Sanchez. Definitely a pretty good rivalry that I've seen in some other shows, such as UCW. Now they've kind of brought it over here into AOW. Getting a lot of buzz as of late. Definitely getting more involved in other companies and leagues. Same with Zach Sanchez. Zach's kind of just keeping himself more exclusive to other shows such as ROX and now AOW, and even Atlas Amplified. From what I heard, he may be making some appearances in some other smaller shows. But here he comes now. Very close match between these two. Honestly, I wasn't sure who was going to win. Zach, I'm not going to say he got lucky, because you don't really just get lucky in a match. It's like, just bad. Especially with someone that you've had some issues with in the past. You don't just get lucky. You get it. Zach is definitely going to want to pick up the win here tonight. Zach Sanchez going one-on-one one last time. The referee rings the bell. Both men lock up. Zach with the side headlock. Oh, has him by the arm. Juan comes around with a hold of his own. But Zach, both men just switching holds on each other. And Zach able to roll out of it. Both men lock up once again. And Zach tripping Juan. Just letting him get up. Wow, kind of surprised there. Oh, Juan reverses. He was going for there into an elbow. Oh, is Zach coming back with the exact same reversal? Oh, backing him into a corner. Is this off into the corner? And a drop kick. Juan landing right into that second turnbuckle. Hyped up here. Oh, what is this? Oh, wow. Nice move there by Zach. Ties to the top rope. What is this? Taunting Juan now. And oh my god, I don't really know what he was going for there, but I do not think he connected with that right. But he may have been going for a DDT from the top rope, but that did not end well at all. This Hurricane Rana and Zach as Juan rolls out of the ring, very wise there. Off the ropes goes Zach. And oh, got a front flip senton over the top rope, just landing on Juan, wasting very little time here. And drives him back first into the barricade and then throws him back into the ring. Telling Juan to get up. What's he looking to do here? Oh, got a slingshot spear. Just taking him down. Oh, Juan looks to take back control now. Oh, it's a combination of elbows. Man. Six. 7, 8, oh my god, 9, and 10 elbows right to the heart of Zach Sanchez. Oh, and a kick right to the back of the head. Oh, shrewd. Now throws Zach off the ropes. Oh, nice arm drag. Trying to do now. So with a heel kick, and now Santos heads to the top rope. Oh my god! So with a corkscrew moonsault goes to the pin. Two. No. Close call there for Zach Sanchez. Juan almost had him. Also kind of surprised he didn't get him. And a European uppercut. Back Juan Santos, and what is this? Another elbow to the heart of Zach. What's this? Puts him off the rope. Oh, Zach able to hang on. And then staring each other down. Oh, Zach getting the first hit in. Now brings him back. Oh, but wait a minute. With a belly-to-belly suplex. Taking back control of this matchup, it seems like. Just taunts Zach as he gets up. Go. Close line. Takes him down. Oh, nice roundhouse. That's what I'm looking for here. Zach throws him over. Comes back into an elbow. I've seen this before from Juan. Now here comes. What I'd like to call a very sensational combination. Lifts Zach up. What is he going for now? Oh! Hits him with that leg lariat. He has put many opponents away with one, two, no. I don't know how, but Zach Sanchez able to kick out. But Juan, once again with that elbow. At this point, you can tell he's just getting pissed off. He just wants this match to be over, probably. And a hurricane rana to Zach. What is this? Oh, is Zach with a backflip getting out of it? Oh, an insecurity! I think that's gonna put Juan away here. If that caught him with the insecurity out of nowhere. Not expecting that at all. Going for the pin. One, two, no! Juan now kicking out of Zach's best move. Just dropping his knee right into the kidney area. Now what's he looking to do? Oh, Zach with a clothesline. And another one. So with a third, what is he going to do now? Now a drop kick. Zach goes off the ropes. And hits him with a sunset powerbomb. And right into the ropes. If he was going to go for the pin. Had to stop himself though, because he realized right where he put Juan. As he leaned up against the ropes now, what is this? Oh, a knee right to the midsection. That could not have felt good at all. Zach, if you're gonna want to win, you gotta put him away soon. Once again, has him. Oh, wait a minute, throwing Juan out of the ring. What's he looking for here? Zach off the ropes. And a tornado DDT! That suicide tornado DDT. Let's look at it one more time. As he plants Juan's head into the canvas. The referee starts the count. One. Juan with a belly to belly suplex now taking control. Oh, got a nice backbreaker. Jeez, what the hell even was that? Just drop Zach face first onto the outside. Oh no, here we go again with this combination of strikes. Been awfully close here. Oh, wait a minute. Oh god, what a heel kick by Juan. The count of eight, we're getting awfully close here. 9. Oh, come on, Juan. You're going to take the count out win. 10. Wait, hold on. Okay, I'm getting word that something's happening backstage. Hold on, can we get the cameras going back there? Oh, wait a minute. Sebastian Scott and King DRS going at it right now. Oh, DRS throwing Sebastian into that crate. Hold on a minute. Juan Santos was also outside of the ring during that count. I guess that match is ending in a draw. But anyways, we have King DRS just beating the hell out of Sebastian Scott right now backstage. I don't know what happened, but how this altercation got started. DRS, what is he looking to do here? He just drags Sebastian through the backstage area. Where's he taking him? Oh no, I think he's taking him towards the parking lot. Oh, just throwing him to the ground. Just stomping on him a little bit. Man, DRS. I did not think this rivalry was this personal. Oh my god! Dropping him on the concrete. DRS grabbing the fire extinguisher. Oh, look at that, just spraying him. Oh, that could not have felt good at all. Oh my Jesus Christ. DRS just hitting Sebastian in the back of the head with that fire extinguisher. Now what's he doing? God, this is just brutal. Throwing him to the floor. Oh man, just stomping on his back now. God, DRS just, honestly, I don't think I've ever seen DRS get this extreme and this brutal. What's he doing now? Not like where this is going. This is not going to end well for either of these. Well, honestly, who knows? At this point, these guys are just, well, I'd say they were going to beat, they're beating out. Oh my god, just driving him face first into that concrete. As I was saying, though, I'd say they're beating the hell out of each other, but no, this is all DRS. He's just destroying Sebastian Scott. Oh no. Where is this going? Oh no. Has Sebastian up on that limo. This is not going to end well. Oh god. Straight punch to the face. What is he? Oh no. Don't tell me he's going to. Oh god. Hooks the arms. And a pedigree on top of that limo. I think that's it. Well, I guess we'll just see you all at Anarchy.